Assalamualaikum dear students, how are you? I hope you all are fine with your family at home. I am also fine. This is Kamrun Nahar, assistant teacher of English, National Ideal English Version School, Day Shift. Today I am going to take an English language class for the students of class 4. And our today's topic is interjection. At first, we will read these sentences. Okay, let's read. Number 1, hooray, I have won the first prize. Number 2, hello, how are you? Number 3, hey, what have you done? Number 4, the plan did not work. Now, look at these sentences. The word hooray, hello, hey, are interjections because they show our strong emotions. Hooray express the emotion of happiness, and we use hello to greet someone. We use hey to show our strong feeling of surprise. We use to show our sadness. So these words are called interjections. So what is interjections? Interjections are the words which are used to express our strong feelings. So let's read. An interjection is a word which is used mostly at the beginning of a sentence or in a conversation to express a deep or sudden emotion. It is followed by an exclamation mark. Now look, there is an exclamation mark. So the interjections are followed by exclamation mark. And it is used at the beginning of the sentences. And interjections have some interesting features. And what are they? Interjections don't have a grammatical function in the sentence construction. Now look, if I hide the word hooray, we will find I have won the first prize. Now look at this sentence. It expresses a complete sense. That means if we hide or omit hooray, it will not affect this sentence. That means the word hooray is not related to this sentence and it will not change the structure of this sentence. Now next one, they usually cannot be modified. That means we can't change these words or modify these words. Like we can change the verb into adverb or adjective. So it will not be changed. They are highly context sensitive. That means we will use interjections according to the circumstances or situations. Now look at these examples. If you use hello instead of hooray, what will happen? It will not be correct. That means you can't express your emotions properly because we use hello to greet someone and we use hooray to express the feelings of happiness or joy. So that's why we need to know the use of interjections in different situations. So now look, we can use interjections in different situations. There are some examples. Interjections for greeting. That means these interjections are used to greet any person. Hi, how's everyone at home? Hello, I'm talking to you. Hey, listen to me. So hi, hello, hey, these interjections are used to greet someone or any person. Now interjections for joy. So interjections for joy are used to show the strong feeling of or emotion of happiness. Hooray, my article is published in the magazine. Wow, the bird is so beautiful. Yippee! We are going for a picnic. Now look, these sentences expresses, or I mean these words expresses our feeling of joy. So we will use hooray, wow, yippee to express the feelings of joy or happiness. Now interjections for surprise. We use interjections for surprise to show intense emotion on something that has happened or that surprised us. Ah, what have you done? Oh, what a glorious victory. What? You are not performing. Hey, you have spoiled the dish. Now look, these words, I mean interjections, ah, oh, what, hey, shows the emotion of surprise. So we will use these interjections when we become surprised or when we want to express our emotion. Now interjections for grief or pain. We use this type of interjections to show our sadness or pain in any unfortunate event or situation. Now look, alas, his father died yesterday. Ouch, I have hurt my knee. Ah, our plan has failed. Oh, the story was really sad. Now look, we use ah and oh in both situations. That means to express our feeling or emotion of surprise or to express our feeling or emotion of grief or pain or sadness. Now interjections for approval. And we use interjections for approval to approve, to express our emotion, to approve something that has occurred. Okay, let's read. Bravo, Ria has stood first. Brilliant, your writing is flawless. Splendid, I like your work. Well done, you have got the highest marks. Now look, we will use these interjections to show our strong feelings of approval. So in our lesson, we have learned which words are called interjections, and we have also learned how to use interjections in different situations. That means how to use our expressions using different interjections in sentences. We use interjections in spoken languages to show our reaction to something which influences our emotions or feelings, and we usually don't use interjections in formal language or writing because it's not appropriate. Now look, students, there is a homework for you. Homework number 2. Fill in the blanks with suitable interjections from the box. Let's read the word or interjections. Hooray, brilliant, what, wow, ouch, hello, alas, bravo. So you will use these interjections to fill in the blanks. I mean you will complete these sentences using these interjections. Okay, let's read these sentences. Number A, dash, that's really a great news. Number B, dash, I am undone. Number C, dash, we have won the match. Number D, dash, you have done well. Number E, dash, where are you going now? Number F, dash, your plan is outstanding. Number G, dash, I have hurt my toe. Number H, dash, you have broken the showpiece. So you will use these interjections or words to fill in the blanks or to complete these sentences. So dear students, I hope you have understood our today's topic, and you will do your assigned homework in your homework copy. You will submit all your homework copies on every Sunday within 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. in the school library, and your parents or guardians can come to submit or collect those copies. And your SBA sitting and timers will be given on the basis on the submission of your homework copy. So do your homework regularly. So that's all for today. Study regularly and obey your parents. See you again. Allah Hafiz.